What's up, family? As we are waiting for this delicious Pompano to cool down, I want to explain to you guys why we haven't been producing much videos lately, and it's straight up just getting skunked. We're trying to get into this whole land-based shark fishing, and it's totally new to us, and we're not experienced at it. We bought new gear, we bought a new kayak, we bought a 50 wide avet to use, and we're learning how to go drop baits. And it just hasn't been going that well. But yeah, it's a learning process and we're continuing to do that. Yesterday, we were mainly going to go shark fishing and we went to the beach over by Jamaica in Galveston. We went pretty early and everything was perfect. It was beautiful, there wasn't much people. That's what I was scared about. But when we got there, the waves were calm, perfect conditions. I've been looking at this like week before how the conditions are gonna be because I'm new at this. I don't wanna go risk my life. Laura can't actually swim, so her watching me out there dying, either I'm getting attacked by a shark or, you know, something happens, I don't know. And she can't do nothing, you know, we've already talked about it, like if something does happen, you just gotta let it happen. But if we can, we bought walkie-talkies, which the very first time that I went out just to test drive it, I flipped over and I lost the walkie-talkie. Supposedly a floating walkie-talkie, but yeah, we never found it. And anybody who does find it, you know as I know, ain't nobody gonna give you that stuff back. So that was a bummer. Already feel unsafe, but the waves were calm. But as we were starting to set our stuff up, I'm looking at the surf and the waves are not being too, they're starting to get like higher than me. And yeah, it started to look unsafe, but I was like, you know what, we're already here, we're gonna go try it. So I did go try it. I didn't look at it, I was like, I'm not gonna go do it. I was like, no, I wouldn't go try it. As I went to go try it, of course, I flipped over. And yeah, it was just getting pretty bad. And on top of that, the more the time that went by, it was getting packed. It was getting so packed that people were like feet away, like just parking right next to each other. And the lines were starting to shift to the right, and it was getting too dangerous because people were swimming there. We were like, you know what, we gotta cut it, we gotta go. We're just gonna have to take an L on this and just be unsuccessful with this fishing. We've never seen this before. I feel like it is, the coronavirus has a big thing to do with it because everybody was supposed to stay at home and now people, you know, are going out, and what better to go do than to go hit up the beach. They packed everything up, we went towards the piers. We're like, hey, if we can go onto 91st, let's go into 91st. We'll see how it is. Cars everywhere, so busy. We drove, I'm pretty sure, for like 20 minutes.
Yeah.
20 minutes trying to find a spot. We even called the piers before, like, hey, how long is the wait? 91st we didn't call because we could clearly see the line. So then we went to 61st Street Pier. We called, they're like, oh, there's no waiting, just get right in. We're like, oh yeah, that's awesome, we can go fishing there. It was bad. You couldn't park anywhere. Super packed, people parked in places they're not even supposed to be parking at. We had the kayak up on top, so I didn't want to get my stuff stolen. We literally just could not park. So we were like, okay, we're just gonna have to take an L, we're just gonna have to go home, and here goes another non-made video. But we seen that Texas City Dike was only 20 minutes away, so we're like, you know what, we got nothing to lose. We already got our stuff. We can be parked off of the road and just fish from there. We had shrimp, we had some mullet, and yeah, so we went over there, we went fishing, and that's where we got the Pompano.
Oh my God. What is that?
Big freaking Pompano!
Yo, that's cool!
We were literally talking about this like the other day, like, hey, there's fish that we gotta try. And Pompano was on our list. But people are saying that this is some of the best eating fish. So that's awesome. PB, first Pompano ever.
It was crazy because like 2 weeks earlier, or a few days earlier, me and Laura were talking about our last catch and cook. If you guys haven't checked that out, shiggity, check it out for me. Please like, share, subscribe, and love you. But yeah, we were talking about the Pompano. We were like, yo, like, we gotta try it. It's rare to get it here in Texas. And the size that we got, I was like, yo, that's pretty big. I still wanted to check the size of it. But Laura checked that it's such a rare fish here in Texas. If you got one, yo, put it in your cooler, cook it up, and take it. Like, the guy next to us was like ecstatic about us catching the Pompano. He's like, yo, you gotta keep that. It's like $6 a pound. You gotta try it. Or some of you guys know I don't eat fish. But people are saying this is some of the best fish that you can try. So we are excited to try this out and let you guys know. All we used was lemon pepper. And then we fried it. And I'm normally catch and release. You guys know from my other videos, I'm normally always catch and release, but I was like, you know what? We lost $100 and something. I told Laura we should show a video of how expensive it is for us who travel from Houston all the way to Galveston to do some saltwater fishing. It gets pretty expensive. So yeah, we were blessed with this Pompano. We brought it back. We didn't freeze it. We just cut it open. We marinated it and we wanted to have it as fresh as possible. So we're pretty excited about that. Also, we learned how to cast net.
Oh yes.
This old guy came up to us and he was like, hey, I see you're struggling. I'm like, bro, I am struggling. He was like, let me teach you how to cast that. And I was like, yo, in a minute, I was catching so much bait, I was giving it to the people next to me. And I was doing it for fun. I was just telling Laura, I'm like, okay, this one's for fun. I would catch some and then I would let them go. But yeah, in the future too, we're gonna do a video on how to cast net because fishing is expensive. If you guys can learn ways of getting your own bait, simply getting your own bait, like, yo, that'll help you out a lot. So I'm gonna do a video in the future on how to cast net. Super simple. In a minute, you'll be catching your own bait and save yourself some money. But yeah, we're gonna try the Pompano. We're gonna see what's up. Let's try this. Let's try this. This fish right here, to me is like a $200 fish because that's probably how much we lost that
day. Oh my gosh, yeah. I like it.
Bro, that's straight up chicken.
Yes! I wanted you to say it before I did.
That is straight up chicken. What?
Oh, be careful. One might have bones.
We suck at filleting.
Yeah, so I filleted this time.
She did fillet.
I sucked.
I mean, I wouldn't have done any better at all, but.
I don't know, you did pretty great with the catfish.
This is straight up chicken. Like, if I told somebody to close their eyes and try this, they would say it's straight up chicken.
Do you want to try it in a taco with some guac?
Yeah. Yo! I might like fish after all. It might have been lying to everybody. I don't like fish. I'm a picky fish eater. Does the skin have a lot of fishy taste to it?
No comment. I ate most of the guac, I'm sorry.
Okay, I don't like the skin.
Yeah.
It's not too strong, but I don't like the skin. Maybe if it was a little more fried that I would, but. I mean, I'll try some weird stuff and I'll like it, but I'm a pretty delicate eater.
Fill the Pompano.
Now again, like I've said before, in my other catch and cooks, if you didn't watch it, go watch it. But if the fish doesn't taste good by itself, then I don't consider it being a good tasting fish. I come from a Hispanic family that feels that they need to douse it with a bunch of Cholula sauce, red hot sauce, a bunch of limon and this and that. And I'm like, just hiding the flavor of the actual fish. But I can guarantee you, anybody who says they don't like fish, if you tried pompano, just lemon pepper, and pan fried it, it is legit.
It's like a chicken wrap, chicken taco.
That is a $200 fish right there. That might even be the title of the video.
Oh my god.
$200 fish.
Yeah.
So yeah, the fish, pompano, when you land one, keep it. Just some lemon pepper, and then pan fry it, deep fry it, or put it on the grill. It's legit. From a person who doesn't really eat a lot of fish, I'm telling you guys from the bottom of my heart, that is some good tasting fish. For everybody who still watches, thank you guys very much. A lot of love. And till next time, it's your boy V. It's Laura. Till next time.